अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडेज़ लेक्चर इंक्लूड द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द आई एग्जाम। एज वी हैव स्टडीड दैट आई असेसमेंट इज डन इन फाइव पार्ट्स। दीज आर जनरल इंस्पेक्शन, टेस्टिंग फॉर विजुअल एक्विटी, टेस्टिंग फॉर विजुअल फील्ड्स, असेसिंग फॉर एक्स्ट्रा ऑक्युलर मसल फंक्शनिंग एंड ऑफ्थैल्मिक एग्जाम। सो वी हैव डन विद द फर्स्ट टू पार्ट्स ऑफ दिस आई एग्जाम। टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द रिमेनिंग थ्री पार्ट्स। First of all, we will study about testing visual field. Visual field is tested by confrontation test. This test assesses peripheral visual fields to determine functions of the retina and neuronal visual pathways to the brain and the second cranial nerve, which is named as optic nerve. To perform this test, have the client sit directly facing you at a distance of 60 to 90 centimeter or 2 to 3 feet. Then ask the client to cover the right eye with a card and look directly at your nose. Then cover or close your eye directly opposite to the client's covered eye, that will be your left eye, and look directly at the client's nose. Then look at each other's uncovered eyes. Hold an object, for example a pen light or pencil, in your fingers. Extend your arms and move the object into the visual fields from various points in the periphery. The object should be at an equal distance from the client and yourself. Ask the client to tell you when the moving object is first spotted in the periphery, or wiggle your fingers and instruct the person to indicate when finger is first seen. Bring your hand in along main axis of the visual fields. These are four in number: superior, inferior, temporal, or nasal. This diagram is showing the range of peripheral vision. So what is range of peripheral vision? Temporally, peripheral objects can be seen at a right angle or 90 degree to the central point of vision in a normal eye. The superior or upward field of vision is normally 50 degree because the orbital ridge is in the way. The downward field of vision is normally 70 degree because the cheekbone is in the way. The nasal field of vision is normally 50 to 60 degrees away from the central point of vision because the nose is in the way. As the diagram is showing, 50 degrees superiorly, 90 degrees temporally, and 70 degrees in inferior, and 60 degrees nasally. Normal findings are, when looking straight ahead, a client can see object in the periphery, and abnormal findings involve visual field smaller than normal. This is due to possible glaucoma. One half vision or one in one or both eyes. This is due to possible nerve damage, is maybe the second abnormal finding. Extraocular muscle test. This test assesses six ocular movement to determine eye alignment and coordination, and also test cranial nerve 3, 4, and 6. Extraocular muscle test is done by three tests. These are number one, cardinal position of gaze. On second comes the corneal light reflex, and third comes covered or uncovered test. Cardinal positions of gaze. To perform this test, stand directly in front of the client and hold the pen light at a comfortable distance, such as 30 cm or 1 feet in front of the client's eyes. Then ask the client to hold the head in a fixed position facing you and to follow the movement of the pen light with the eyes only. Move the pen light in a slow, orderly manner through the six cardinal fields of the gaze, and that is from the center of the eye along the lines of the arrows in and back to the center. Then stop the movement of the pen light periodically so that the nystagmus can be detected. This diagram is showing the six muscles of the eye, and this diagram is showing the innervation of the cranial nerve in the extraocular muscles. Normal findings involve both eyes coordinated, move in unison or harmony with parallel alignment. And abnormal findings involve eye movement not coordinated or parallel. One or both eyes fail to follow a pen light in a specific directions, for example in strabismus or cross eye or squint, a condition in which both eyes do not look at the same place at the same time. Or nystagmus, this is a rapid involuntary rhythmic eye movement, may indicate neurological impairment. So on the second comes corneal light reflex, or the second name is Hirschberg test. Parallel alignment of the eye axis, it is done by assessing for location of the light reflex by shining pen light on the corneal surfaces. To perform this test, ask the client to look straight ahead then shine a pen light on the bridge of his nose from 12 to 15 inches or 30.5 to 38 centimeter away. Then observe the reflection of the light of the cornea, which should appear as a pinpoint white light near the center of the pupil in each eye. If there is normal alignment, the reflection will be appear in the same position in each pupil as the diagram is showing. This is the normal alignment and corneal reflex. If there is misalignment of the eyes, the location of the corneal reflex will appear asymmetric and off the center of the pupil in the deviating eye. Estropia, this is eye turned inward and the image may be outward. And ectropia, eye turned outward. Hypertropia, eye turned upward. And hypotropia, eye turned downward. The relative difference in the position of the reflex will be in the opposite direction as the eye deviation. For example, in an estropia, where there is inward deviation of the eye, the light reflex will appear outwardly displaced from the center of the pupil. As the diagram is showing. And in hypertropia, where there is an upward deviation of the eye, the light reflex will appear inferiorly displaced from the center of the pupil. This worked oppositely. On the third comes cover or uncover test. To assess steady fixed gaze or detect deviation in alignment, we will do this cover test. To perform this test, have the client fixate on a near or far object. Cover one eye and observe for movement in the uncovered eye. This is a cover test. And findings: uncovered eye doesn't move. If misalignment is present when dominant eye is covered, the uncovered eye will move to focus to the object. Cover or uncover test. Normal eyes are aligned, no movement of the either eyes. And abnormal findings are phoria. This means latent misalignment of the eye exists. Ophthalmic exam. Ophthalmic exam is done by using ophthalmoscope. So what is ophthalmoscope? The ophthalmoscope allows you to directly observe the client's internal structures, and then use the green positive numbers on the ophthalmoscope lens to lens discs to focus on near objects such as the patient cornea and lens, and use the red minus numbers to focus on distant objects such as retina. Ophthalmoscope enlarges the view of the inner eye. Beam of light through the pupil illuminates inner structures of the eye. The diagram is showing the ophthalmoscope. To perform this test, before beginning the examination, ask the patient to remove his contact lenses or eyeglasses. Then darken the room to dilate patient's pupils and make your examination easier. Ask the patient to focus on a point behind you and instruct the patient to look at the distant point and keep focused. Hold with your right hand when inspecting right eye. Set the lens disc at 0 diopter and then hold the ophthalmoscope about 4 inches or 10 centimeter from the patient's eye and direct the light through the pupil to elicit the red reflex. Begin 15 degrees lateral to the person line of vision. Shine ophthalmoscope to the right pupil. Then check the red reflex for depth of color. Red reflex is caused by the reflection of the light off in the inner retina. Orange red coloration of fundus anterior chamber, and which is visible through pupil. Move towards person's till examiner's forehead almost touches the thumb placed on the person's forehead. Move scope towards the positive numbers gradually. Inspect anterior chamber and lens for transparency and then rotate lens back to zero. Then focus on the retinal structures. Rotate lens to the sharpest focus. Inspect optic disc. If can't find, follow up vein along and it will lead to the disc. Findings may be, first of all, ocular fundus is examined. जनरल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ फंडस कलर नॉर्मली वेरीज फ्रॉम लाइट रेड टू डार्क ब्राउन. रेड जनरली कॉरिस्पॉन्डिंग विद स्किन कलर. एंड व्यू शुड बी क्लियर विदाउट लेजन्स ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग रेटिनल स्ट्रक्चर्स. लुक फॉर क्लाउडिंग फॉरिन मैटर और एनी ओपेसिटीज. एन ओपेक लेंस इंडिकेट कैटरेक्ट्स एंड यू मे नॉट बी एबल टू कम्प्लीट योर एग्जामिनेशन इफ ए कैटरेक्ट इज प्रेजेंट. After this, optic disc is visualized. Optic disc on the nasal side of the retina, and color is creamy yellow, orange to pink. Shape round or oval. Margins are distinct and sharply demarcated. Nasal edge may be slightly fuzzy. Retina. Completely scan the retina by following four blood vessels from the optic disc to different peripheral areas. The retina should have a uniform color and be free from scars and any pigmentation. Macula. Move the light laterally from the optic disc to locate the macula, the part of the eye most sensitive to light. It appears as a darker structure free from blood vessels. As the diagram is showing the internal structure of the eye, retina and the optic disc, macula, fovea centralis and the physiological cup. Physiological cup is a slightly depressed and lighter in color than the remainder of the cup. The cup occupies one second of the disc diameter. Cup disc ratio. When visible, physiological cup is a brighter yellow white and width is not more than half disc diameter. Sample charting. After the eye assessment, we will chart the findings, and these are objective findings as Snellen chart. Right eye 20/20 and left eye vision is 20/20. Peripheral vision is intact by confrontation. Corneal light reflex is symmetric bilaterally, and diagnostic position test shows extraocular muscles intact. And brows and lashes are present. No ptosis, conjunctiva is clear, sclera white without jaundice. No lesions and perla is present. Fundi red reflex present bilaterally. Disc flat with sharp margins. Vessels present in all the quadrant without crossing defects. And retinal background has even color with no hemorrhages or exudate. Macula has even color. Refractive errors. Refractive errors means that the shape of your eye does not bend light correctly, which result in a blurred image. The main types of refractive errors are myopia or nearsightedness, hyperopia or farsightedness, presbyopia, loss of near vision with age, and astigmatism. Myopia. Close objects are clear and distant objects are blurry. Myopia, also known as nearsightedness, myopia is usually inherited and often discovered in childhood. Myopia often progresses throughout the teenage years when the body is growing rapidly. Hyperopia or farsightedness is a common vision problem affecting about a fourth of the population. People with hyperopia can see distant objects very well but have difficulty in focusing on objects that are up close. The condition is sometimes referred to as hypermetropia rather than hyperopia. Presbyopia, that is aging of the lens in the eye. After age 40, the lens of the eye becomes more rigid and doesn't flex as easily. As a result, the eye loses its focusing ability and it becomes more difficult to read at a close range. This normal aging process of the lens can also be combined with myopia, hyperopia or astigmatism. Usually occurs when the front surface of the eye, the cornea, has an asymmetric curvature. Normally the cornea is smooth and equally curved in all directions, and light entering the cornea is focused equally on all planes or in all directions. In astigmatism, the front surface of the cornea is covered more in one direction, curved more in one direction than in another. This abnormality may result in vision that is much like looking into a distorted or wavy mirror. Usually astigmatism causes blurred vision at all distances. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द एग्जाम ऑफ द आई. थैंक यू.